I'm Milton Magnus. I am president and third generation owner of M&B Hangers in Leeds, Alabama. M&B Hangers is a company that manufactures wire clothes hangers for the dry clean industry and the textile rental industry.
My great-grandfather started the business, so I'm fourth generation. We've had a lot of multi-generation employees here, and it's really just become a family. We are by far the oldest manufacturer still in this market. Started in 1943, so we've got 74 years in. We're heavily invested into being a U.S. manufacturer.
You look back to the year 2000, in the United States, there were 17 hanger plants, five large companies that made hangers. By 2008, the plant in Leeds, Alabama was the only plant left in the United States making hangers. We were actually competing with people selling product at less than our raw material cost in the product. So for us to be able to compete with companies in Asia, we have to automate. And we have to make more hangers with less dollars spent.
So we started off with zero experience in robots. Thankfully, our engineer at the time had done some work with Fitz-Thors in the past with a different company. And so we got hooked up with Fitz-Thors, and from that point on, they got excited about the project and took it and ran with it. And we were just holding on and running with them.
Our company was started in 2007, and it didn't take long before we had opportunities. Our local KUKA rep had established a relationship with M&B, learned more about their process, and recommended us as a local solution provider that could develop a custom robotic solution for their application.
This really was a partnership between M&B and Fitz-Thors. They really had the know-how on how to produce coat hangers. Obviously, that's not something that people come across very often.
You know, the process of manufacturing hangers is more automated now than it used to be. The hanger machines run faster, but they're still taking a piece of wire and bending it, twisting it, hooking it, forming it, and painting it, and putting it in the box. The process has changed a little bit, but the actual machinery has changed very little over the years.
So these robots have been in operation about 6 months. It's been a major learning curve, but they have greatly outproduced what I thought where we would be today. We've been able to increase our output on the automation side by 2.5 times over the manual side. We've been very happy with the system. We look at it and we just see how much potential we have moving forward, and also moving forward with automation. We are in a growth phase, so we are hiring employees. It's shifting where our employees work in the plant. They're moving more towards the preliminary processes and away from the finishing processes, but it has allowed us to hire more people. One of the major benefits we've seen with the automation system has been the fact that every hanger is checked and every hanger is checked to spec.
I think it's really made better consistency. We've been able to get data on how many boxes are we producing in a day, in a shift, each hour, and it can help make the process more reliable.
We can track all of our information through a vision system. When the hanger is ejected from the machine, it has a picture taken of it, it's measured the critical points, and then it either gets rejected or accepted.
I absolutely could see in the future using this data to make more educated decisions and be able to monitor that remotely from inside their main building. You can take that data and make it into a smart factory for sure.
KUKA and its products have been great. Anytime we've had a question, anytime we've needed to contact KUKA directly, they have been right there for us.
It's a full team that we can rely on and we can work together with to really finish out an application. I'm very glad that we ended up using KUKA for this system because of the Agilis. It filled in a gap in the market where there wasn't that medium size and medium payload robot, and that probably made the biggest difference. It made it to where I would say it was possible.
We've had great results so far with KUKA robots. We're learning KUKA robots, we're learning how to program them, and that's where we want to go in the future. We view this automation cell as our first step in many more. We view it as how we're going to move forward and how we're going to keep our input costs low and be able to compete with whoever comes along. we're here to stay, and we're going to be here for many, many more years.
Orange Intelligence.